Hey friends, welcome. Today we are going to discuss different types of adsorption isotherm. Now basically this adsorption isotherm are different types of graphs which are generated basically because of the adsorption of any gas molecule or adsorption of a gas on variety of adsorbent surfaces at different temperatures. This adsorption isotherms, they are broadly classified into five different types wherein they are given the name, that is type 1, 2, 3, 4 and type 5. Now basically this adsorption isotherms are the curves or graphs between the amount of gas adsorbed, that is amount of gas adsorbed, generally we can represent it by x by m also, which is from our Friedlich isotherm, and the pressure p. And this adsorption isotherms, they can also be classified on the basis of that the type 1, 2 and 3, they represent the non-porous type of adsorption, and type 4 and 5, they represent the porous type of the adsorbent material. Okay, so one by one in detail we will discuss all the five types of the adsorption isotherm. First adsorption isotherm, that is when we plot a curve of amount of gas adsorbed versus pressure, then the adsorption curve is of this type, wherein initially there is an increase of the amount of gas on or amount of adsorption, and after certain period of time the curve, it gets flattened, or the saturation will take place. So this type of curve can be explained by taking, suppose this is our adsorbent material, and on this adsorbent material our gas molecules are sitting or gas molecules are getting adsorbed. So only a monolayer adsorption will take place, and after the formation of monolayer will take place, saturation or our graph will become a flat. So this type of adsorption, it is as observed in case of Friedlich adsorption isotherm or Langmuir adsorption isotherm, where there is a formation of monolayer is taking place. So this is the type 1. So the example of this type of adsorption is that adsorption of say nitrogen or hydrogen on charcoal at minus 180 degree centigrade, it is a monolayer adsorption. And suppose if we consider that even is the heat of adsorption for the first layer, okay, even is the heat of adsorption for the first layer, and EL is the heat of liquefaction for the remaining layers, that is for second, third, fourth and so on layer. So for type 1 adsorption, EL will be equal to 0 because there is no formation of second, third layer, only there is a monolayer adsorption taking place. So this is our first type of adsorption isotherm. Now moving on to type 2 adsorption isotherm. So in case of type 2 adsorption isotherm, amount of adsorbed gas versus pressure, when we plot it, then again there is an increase in the adsorption, and after that there will be an inflation in the adsorption observed. So inflation, I can draw it in this particular manner. So inflation will be observed, and this adsorb or this type of curve we have seen in case of our wet adsorption isotherm, wherein initially there is a formation of monolayer. So up to this particular point there is a formation of monolayer, and after that there will be a formation of multilayer taking place, and this we have seen in case of the wet adsorption isotherm, and this also can be explained through wet adsorption isotherm. So the diagrammatic representation, we can show it by that. Suppose this is our adsorbent surface, and on this adsorbent surface first the monolayer adsorption will take place. After monolayer adsorption there will be a formation of multilayer taking place. So second layer, third layer, fourth layer will take place. So up to here we will have monolayer adsorption, and above here we will have multilayer adsorption, and hence this type of adsorption will take place, and this As I told, it can be explained by wet adsorption isotherm, and over here energy of liquefaction is less than the heat of adsorption for the first layer, because as first layer or as first adsorption layer is, or adsorption is taking place, or monolayer is forming, and after that multilayer is forming, multilayer adsorption is taking place. And the example of this type of adsorption is adsorption of nitrogen on iron or platinum catalyst at say minus 195 degree centigrade. So adsorption of nitrogen on iron or platinum as a catalyst at 195 degree centigrade is an example of this type of adsorption, that is multilayer adsorption. And over here, as we are discussing adsorption isotherms, always we need to mention the temperature, because at a specific temperature only this type of behavior will be shown by different types of curves. Now moving on to the third type of adsorption isotherm. The third type of adsorption isotherm, so when we plot a curve between the pressure and the amount of gas adsorbed, then in this there will be a continuous increase in the adsorption till the saturation pressure. Now over here this type of adsorption can be explained by taking the example that suppose this is again our adsorbed surface, and on this adsorbent surface first certain amount of molecules are adsorbed on our adsorbent surface. Now after that the incoming molecules which are coming, they have an option that either they can sit in between or sit at the vacant space forming the first layer, or they can sit on the first layer and form the multilayer. So over here in this case, as the heat of liquefaction is greater than the heat of formation of a monolayer, the incoming molecule will sit on, or it will sit on the molecule or on the first layer of the molecule, and as a result directly multilayer will form. Okay, so as no monolayer is forming, because this type of curve is for our monolayer, so as you can see that no monolayer is forming and directly multilayer is forming, as the heat of liquefaction is greater than the heat of adsorption of the first layer. As a result direct multilayer is forming. And also there exist several van der Waals forces between the first layer and second layer and third layer. In both the cases, in both the, there are van der Waals forces between the adsorbed molecule. And the example of this type of adsorption is the adsorption of bromine on silica at 80 degree centigrade. Adsorption of bromine on silica is an example of this type of adsorption. So moving on to the fourth adsorption type. Now fourth adsorption type and fifth adsorption type are the examples for porous adsorption. Generally over here the adsorbent, it contains narrow capillary pores, and suppose this is our adsorbent and it suppose contains narrow capillary pore, then the type 4 of adsorption, the curve can be shown by this. First the formation of monolayer is taking place, and after that inflection will take place, and this is the inflection point. So the curve can be explained by taking that this, suppose this is our adsorbent, so initially the first layer of adsorption will take place, or monolayer of adsorption will take place up to here, and after that as we increase the pressure, then this monolayer will start condensing inside the capillary pore. This will start condensing inside the capillary pore, and the incoming layer will sit on this monolayer. So as a result there is a formation, or there is a phenomenon of condensation of the molecules or of the gas molecules which are present on the monolayer will take place, and the incoming molecule will sit on that, and as a result there will be a formation of multilayer will take place on the monolayer, and that is explained, or that is shown by this type of, that is increasing type of behavior. And the example of type 4 type of adsorption isotherm is given by adsorption of benzene on silica at 50 degree centigrade is an example of type 4 type of adsorption isotherm. Now moving on to the final and last type of adsorption isotherm, that is type 5, wherein shown by taking that there is a continuous increase, so it has this type of curve. Now over here, fifth type of adsorption isotherm, it can be shown by taking that suppose this is again our porous adsorbent, and now in fifth type of adsorption isotherm, so one more thing, that over here in fourth type of adsorption isotherm, the energy of liquefaction will be lesser than the formation of monolayer, and as a result what will happen is that only first the monolayer will form and after that the multilayer formation will take place. Now over here in fifth type of adsorption isotherm, the molecule or the incoming gas molecule will directly start condensing, or it will directly start condensing inside the pores, and on the pores then the multilayer or formation of multilayer will take place. Okay, and as a result over here the heat of liquefaction is greater than E1, so over here the monolayer will not be formed or monolayer formation will not take place as shown in the curve, and directly the pore condensation will take place, and then over the pore condensed molecules or over the pore condensed gas molecule, further the adsorption will take place and the multilayer adsorption phenomena will take place, and this type of phenomena is generally known as capillary condensation. It is known as capillary condensation, and the typical example of fifth type of adsorption is the adsorption of water vapor. It is adsorption of water vapor on activated charcoal. Adsorption of water vapor on activated charcoal at 100 degree centigrade is a typical example of type 5 of adsorption. So in nutshell, we can summarize that in type 1, type 2, there is a formation of first in type 1, 2 and type 4, first there is a formation of monolayer, okay, first there is a formation of monolayer, and after that in type 2 and 4 there is a formation of multilayer will take place. Okay, in type 1 multilayer formation is not taking place, so in type 1 only monolayer will take place, and in type 2 and 4 first monolayer formation will take place, and after that multilayer formation will take place, and in type 3 and type 5 directly multilayer formation will take place, and in type 4 and 5 there is a phenomenon of pore condensation observed, wherein the adsorbent that we are taking is a porous material. So hope the explanation was clear. Thank you very much.